this is John Kohler with growingyourgreens.com. Deliver another exciting episode for you. I'm yet on another field trip, and I love taking field trips because field trips are great opportunities to learn. Just like when you're a little kid and you went on field trips to museums and different places, you'd always learn stuff. Well, every field trip I get to go on, I get to learn stuff, and then I get to share that stuff with you. So that's really cool. So today we're at Golden Gate Palms and Exotics. We're here in Point Richmond, California, right off the 580 freeway. I mean, it's running right behind me, and there's a train tracks here, and there's a train just going by. But what we're here today to share with you guys are some relatively unknown fruit trees. Well, technically they're not fruit trees, they're actually palms, and palms, often called palm trees, are not trees at all. They more resemble a grass. And what we're gonna do today is talk about three specific palm trees that can be grown in the California Bay Area that's gonna produce fruit for you. But you know, if you're expecting fruit, like, you know, if you bought a plum tree, you know, they may produce even as short as next year in a few years. These guys, you gotta get them when they're pretty old. Some of them take minimum 12 years to maybe 20 years to start producing for you. But once they do, they'll be around for a long time. Next, I'm gonna go over and show you the three palms that create edible fruit. The first palm we're gonna talk about with edible fruit is right here behind me, and this is called a jelly palm. So the jelly palm, you might think, oh, you know, what do you do with jelly palm fruit? Well, they probably made jelly out of them. This tree is originally from Paraguay and makes some edible fruit, and I see some up there, so let's see if we could find any drop fruit today to see what it's like. So we're in luck here. Looks like this has been dropping some fruit. There's no large fruits on it now. There's some that aren't quite ripe, but if we look down, we could see some of the different fruits. Now, I don't know how it would be if it was, like, fresh, but some of the stuff here looks like it's, you know, kind of dried. Let's see if I could find a good one here. So this is like a little jelly palm fruit here. We're just gonna go ahead and peel off the seed. Now, you know, these are more like wild fruits. Fruits in the wild that aren't basically hybridized have like big seeds and a small amount of fruit. We've hybridized fruit to be a lot sweeter and also have a lot more edible part. So this one doesn't have a whole lot of stuff to eat on it. So let's see here. This is rather dried and they could probably be used fresh, but there's no fresh ones right now. So we're gonna go ahead and try a little bit. Tastes like a dried fruit somewhere between like sour tamarind, not totally sweet, and an apple. Definitely interesting flavor. I've been growing jelly palms for probably about 2 years now. They're quite small and they're slow growers. You can raise them in containers. As you can see, this one's in a large box. It grows well and fruits really well, so even if you don't have a lot of space, you could grow these palms in a container because they don't have a large root structure like many other trees. Next, let's go over to another tree that I'm also already growing at home. So the next tree we're gonna talk about is this guy right here. This is the huge Chilean wine palm. The Chilean wine palm is originally from Chile and grows up in altitude. It'll handle the Bay Area weather no problem whatsoever. And as you can see, it's a really nice palm to look at. It's basically has a straight trunk and really tall, and it produces what's called caquitos, or basically little mini coconuts. They're about the size of a marble, and they taste just like coconut. I've had them before, they're quite delicious. But these guys could take up to like 20 years before they start producing fruit, so it's a slow grower. This one was actually rescued, wasn't always grown in this space. This was rescued and then moved here and saved from being just basically chopped down. So they do grow for definitely a long time. Yes, I'm a certified tree hugger. Well, wait, this isn't a tree, this is a palm. Nonetheless, this tree is ginormous, it's huge. It has nice leaves, and you know, one of the things I always like to do is look down on the ground to look for any fruit that may have dropped. Oh, and look, we may be in luck. This may be the fruit here. This is like a heart. Oh, it's in there, this is cool. So this is like the fruit that it produces. It's like a little coconut. So imagine a coconut. This is just a little miniature version. So if we shake this up, this one's dried. You can hear the little coconut like that's separated from the shell. We're gonna go get two rocks and we're gonna crack this open and show you guys what it looks like inside. We got the Chilean wine palm fruit here. We got two rocks. We're gonna set that on the rock. Take another rock. Now this is truly caveman style. And just crack it. Wow, that's actually a pretty hard nut there. Whoa! Oh, and check it out, this is it. This is the little part that you could eat. So it was, you know, encased in the shell. And this is kind of like a thinner macadamia nut style shell. We're gonna take this and Check it out, right on the inside. Man, that is amazing flavor. Tastes like a coconut times 10, much stronger, much more delicious. Chilean wine palm fruits, definitely one of my favorite. So the last palm that has edible fruit that we're gonna be covering today is this guy right here. This is called the Quito coconut, and this one is actually from Ecuador. And you can see it looks like little miniature coconuts. They're about the size of an egg, and I've never had one of these before either. And this is actually a new tree to me, so I'm not yet growing this, and hopefully one day I'll be growing this soon. But always when you're below a fruit tree, it's always good to look down and see if you can find anything to eat. And check it out, we found a little Quito coconut, and we're gonna go ahead and try to crack this open and show you guys what it's like on the inside. So we're back to our setup with two rocks and caveman style. We're just gonna crush this. Wow, man, there's definitely a husk on this guy. Ugh. It's coming off. Check it out. We could peel this husk off and you can see the nut on the inside. There we go. We got all the husk off. Looks like a little walnut. Let's go ahead and try to crack this little Quito nut open. Man, that's definitely taking a beating. Not open yet. Man, we're cracking the rock in half, man. Third time's a charm. Ugh. Oh, we demolished it in a million pieces. I don't know where it all went, but check it out. We cracked it open and that is a really thick shell. And I'm rewarded with some, man, probably some of the freshest Bay Area grown Quito coconut meat that you've never tasted. And I'm gonna get to try for the first time ever. Wow, that is amazing. It's really nice and fatty and rich. Kind of tastes very similar to a coconut. Mild flavor, but man, so delicious. But these guys are definitely hard to get into, but it's worth the work. Hopefully you guys enjoyed this episode learning more about these three palms that produce edible fruit that can be grown in the climate of the Bay Area. I want to always encourage you guys to seek out and search for new and exciting varieties of trees and plants that produce edible food that you can eat, because that's the spice of life variety. So hopefully you guys enjoyed this episode. Once again, my name is John Kohler with growingyourgreens.com. We'll see you next time and keep on growing.